Hello, today we'll have the discussion on the radius vector. This is a very important vector in the circular motion and the rotational motion, and also it is important in case of the planetary motion. So we'll discuss today about the radius vector. As the name suggests, that this is the vector that is from the center to the circumference of the circular path, and so it is the radius of the circular path. So now we define the position vector. Which is in the direction from center to the circumference of circle. The position vector which is in the direction from the center to the circumference of the circle is called the radius vector, denoted by R. The magnitude of radius vector is equal to the radius of circular path. It means that the magnitude of this R, this is equal to R, the radius. The radius vector is directed away from the center of circular path. Circular path. So it is radially outward. So it is radial outward. Radial outward. So this we can show like this, that we are having this circle. This is now the center of the circle. This is now X axis, this is now y axis, and this is now
point P xy, then this is now radius. This is now radius vector r. In circular motion, the magnitude of radius vector remains constant. But its direction changes continuously. Because as the particle moves in this circular path, now that this is moving in this direction, then you can know that this magnitude will remain the same, but direction will be here on this side. This is now vector r. This is in this way. Radially outward here in this direction, then in this direction, then in this direction, then in this direction, then in this direction. So direction will change all the time. So now let's we draw the perpendicular from here. Then this will be the x. And this is now y. From here, this is now y. In planetary motion, the direction and magnitude of radius vector changes change because planets move in elliptical orbit. Around the sun. So in case of elliptic orbit, the radius is not constant and also the magnitude is not constant, so both are changing continuously. But in case of circular motion, this remains constant. As I have told you, so in this diagram, you can see the radius vector is a two-dimensional vector because it lies in the plane. Of circular path. Circular path. So consider a point PXY on the circumference of circle. Then you will see that this, the radius vector r, this is equal to xi plus yj. So this is in xy plane, xy plane. And if you take the magnitude of this r, then this is equal to square root of x square plus y square. And this is nothing but the radius r equal to square root of x square plus y square. So this is what I have represented this in the xy plane. So this is what the radius. So this is the magnitude of this radius vector r. So this magnitude remains constant in case of the circle. This is in xy plane. Similarly, now this r equal to y j plus z t, this is in y z plane, and r equal to x I plus z k, this is in z x plane. So whether the circle lies in xy plane or yz plane or xz plane, in according to that, it will have the dimensions. If it lies in xy plane, then this is now xi plus yj. If this lies in the yz plane, then this is r is equal to yj plus zk. If it lies in zx plane, then r is equal to xi plus zk. And then the magnitude of this radius. In this one, this will be the square root of y square plus z square. Here, this is now square root of x square plus z square. Now, you can have that if suppose this angle is theta, let this angle is theta, then what will be the angle theta? In xy plane, the angle theta tan theta. Now this tan theta is equal to, this is now y, this is now x, so this is now y upon x. Y upon x, and this from you can have the theta equal to tan inverse y upon x. This is also which? Y upon x. Similarly, we can have in yz plane and zx plane. So this is what the radius vector in case of this circular motion. Now in case of planetary motion, r always changes. Now this we are having the this is now meter axis, this is now minor axis. Here is suppose the sun, this is the sun. Here this now particle is moving like this. Then you can say that if suppose that this is now planet here, then this distance, this is now R. And if suppose this is now at this position, then this is now R. So this is now R, this is now your artist. So R is being changed. As you see that here the value of this R is large and here the value of this RS is equal to. So R is not equal to RS. So they are different ones. So this is suppose at the point P1. This is suppose at point P2. So position vector. Radius vector. At point P1 and P2 are R and RS respectively. So here what we have that this R is not equal to RS. Moreover, its magnitude of R is not equal to magnitude of RS. So neither the this magnitude nor the direction are the same. They are different ones. So we can have that in case of the elliptical motion, the position vector or the radius vector changes from point to point. So the magnitude and the direction both changes continuously in case of planetary motion. So this is about the radius vector. This is very important in case of circular motion and the planetary motion. Importance. The radius vector or position vector is important in circular motion and elliptic and planetary motion. So this is what about radius vector. So thank you very much.